weekend, this past weekend, Trick Daddy was in his hometown of Miami, Florida, where he got pulled over on a traffic stop. I guess he was weaving through streets. He might have been hitting a couple things. Got pulled over. He was asleep at the wheel. Got hit for cocaine possession. I think he had like $100 bill rolled up in a small thing of cocaine, DUI, things like that, man. Yeah. His mugshot came out, and a lot of people had some fun with it. You guys can see that up right there up top. He has something to say about that. Now, we had Snoop Dogg come out in support of Trick Daddy. I think that was the first person publicly, a celebrity I've seen come out and show their support. Other people have followed suit since then, since he's came out and said something. But a lot of celebrities had fun with this. A lot of social media outlets had fun with it. Obviously taking and kicking a brother while he was down. This is what he had to say about it. He said, let me get this right. You lie on me. Make fun of the fact I have lupus and all this just for likes. Thank God I'm strong. Everything is funny until it hits close to home. My feelings don't hurt easily. I'm too worried about waking up tomorrow. Very serious comment. He said he wasn't hurt, but he obviously felt some kind of way about the jokes that were getting thrown his way. Oh, God.
Yeah,
I don't think we've ever talked about this. We did our thing separately, but we never talked about this on the podcast. First off, what did you think about the Trick Daddy situation and then the people on social media having a good time about his downfall at the moment?
Well, you know, I just think, obviously, you know, we don't know all the full details of what went down there. They were alleging a few different things. One, that he was intoxicated, running over things, and that he may have been some cocaine residue inside of a $100 bill. Something like that. But I haven't personally seen anybody make fun of his lupus, but I did hear people making fun of his hairline, and they was talking about, you know what I mean? Not to make, you know, I'm just saying it was kind of funny, some of the stuff. They were like talking about, you know, his barber should be arrested, stuff like that. Right. But lupus, I would never ever, you know, make fun of somebody who has an autoimmune disease like lupus, you know what I mean? You know, because you can't help it. Right. It you know, it's something that's pretty much attacking, you know, pretty much your organs. It could, you know, be your skin, you know, your heart, your lungs, whatever like that. So obviously he has an issue, and it's like, hopefully nobody, I haven't seen it in my comment section, but hopefully nobody out there will go that low where they will make fun of somebody who had lupus. Now, as far as, you know, people going in on him for saying it's his downfall, I don't think like it's his downfall. Maybe, you know, if it did happen, let's just say hypothetically, he DUI, whatever he don't, that's his thing he want to do. Somebody was like, maybe he had to coke the doll, the pain with lupus. I know that people who have lupus, they definitely got a lot of pain. Mm-hmm. So I'm not, you know, giving no excuse, but I'm just going over some of the stuff that I heard. But I don't support that. People going at Trick Daddy you know, shaming him and whatnot for having lupus and stuff like that. I don't support that at all.
I don't think people maybe that were enjoying the joke knew.
Yeah,
he may have been dealing with some things and saw a mugshot and took advantage of a situation. We know how ruthless social media is.
Oh, yeah.
It isn't just your random people that just have Instagram or Facebook platforms to do it. It's your celebrities. I've seen all the celebrities that do their normal thing about the news, making just as much fun as Trick Daddy as everybody else, and then equally run back and say, we need to support. Oh, this was wrong. Bop, 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 bop. You goddamn hypocrites. But it's cool. Mm-hmm. It just is a day and age that we live in, man. People, they love the drama. They love the negativity. They love when somebody can fall on their ass for a second. They love throwing dirt on them while they down, especially when they're under the confines of a phone, nice and comfortable in a place where they can't get touched or they can't get held accountable for what they say behind the cell phone. So Trick Daddy's doing a lot of great things. They got Sundays out there in Miami serving some great food, a lot of fried food. So if you're into fried food, what do you have? Some Cornish hens, fried ribs and shit. He was down there doing his thing. Heard of some great food, giving back to the community. Got caught slipping a little bit. Got caught and hit all over media, and people had a good time. But as like everything else, like that Iranian war we're dealing with and all that shit, things will move on and we'll forget about it.
My thing is, I want to say this because I hear a lot of people that will criticize sometimes, even us, certain platforms, and they're going to say, well, oh, how come you even talking about it? First and foremost, you know, this is a news channel, but it's not even an excuse. It's so many things that we don't talk about, like that other people do, like other websites publish everything. So it's like a process of elimination. And when we do talk about it, we always try to, you know, go somewhere else, you know, with the topic, and hopefully we can get a teaching, you know, moment throughout that whole process. But yeah, man, you know, that's not our thing. We would never want to make fun of nobody. But when things happen, these celebrities and whatnot have to understand that this has come with the territory. You're going to have outlets and medias that are going to do stories when DUIs and things like that happen. It just is what it is. Like, give back the fame, give back the money. And if you don't want it, it comes with it. Just like, you know, anybody else out there, they know this is a part of the territory. You know, you, something happens to you, people are going to go in. The best thing to do is probably not, you know, engage in it, I say.
Yeah. And I don't know if Trick Daddy in the situation was necessarily coming at media outlets, giving and disseminating information more so to people,
right,
clowning them and enjoying a little moment with his mugshot. I mean, because at the end of the day, you got to understand, and I know a lot of the celebrity understand that you, it's a great give and take. Those people are the commentators of your careers, that they move and shift a lot of the reason why you're successful. That's how the people learn and know about you, not only through your social media, but through the media. Yeah. So, I mean, it goes both ways. You just got to pick and decipher what media you decide is the most genuine and authentic and what you're trying to listen to and ride with it. But at the end of the day, negative, positive, whatever. And if it's news, in particular with this platform, hip hop news,
yeah,
important.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely going to talk about it, man. And, you know, just move on. Like you said, it happens today. It's going tomorrow. But ultimately, like I said, shout out to Trick Daddy, you know, what he's got going on down there. You know, hopefully, you know, he can make a full recovery from whatever he's going through in life.
Facts.
Definitely, but you're tuning into the Hip Hop Uncensored podcast with your brother O-God and Sam Ant going in today on this Tuesday. We hope that you're enjoying the podcast. Be sure to hit that 5-star rating and make sure you leave a comment below on the new platform that we're on now. Now, Sam Ant, before we're about to jump into the show today, you'll let me know about Yo Gotti and Jay-Z and them suing a Mississippi prison. I hadn't heard this. I definitely want to hear the details.
Yeah, sure, man. Too. Right after we left the podcast yesterday, I seen it came over my phone that Jay-Z and Yo Gotti were talking to the governor of Mississippi, and they were considering suing over prison conditions. Now, I was like, whoa, this is a crazy headline. I read it, looked through it. I was like, man, they're serious.
Yeah.
Today, it confirmed that they were very serious. Now, attorneys are working with Yo Gotti and Jay-Z to file lawsuits in federal court Tuesday on behalf of 29 inmates against Mississippi federal officials. The lawsuit alleges inmates are being kept in unconstitutional and inhumane conditions. Now, this is something Jay-Z and Yo, this is coming courtesy of the attorney, excuse me. Plaintiffs' lives are in peril. The lawsuit begins. Individuals held in Mississippi prisons are dying because Mississippi has failed to fund its prisons, resulting in prisons where violence reigns because prisons are understaffed. In the past 2 weeks alone, 5 men incarcerated in Mississippi have died as a result of prison violence. These deaths are a result of Mississippi's utter disregard for the people it has incarcerated and their constitutional rights. There's also a video involved in that. I may be able to play that once we go through our commentary. I want to make sure it's clear. I didn't get to listen to it yet. But a recent outbreak of deadly violence that has left 5 inmates dead and an unknown number of others wounds have thrown the brutal conditions at Mississippi prisons into the national spotlight. The Mississippi Department of Corrections has said the violence is gang-related. Prisoners' rights advocates say long-running systematic problems with over-incarceration and underfunding of the prison system created an environment that breeds violence. Lastly, the federal lawsuit was filed against the MDOC Commissioner Policia Hall, who is stepping down this week for a job in the private sector, and the superintendent of the Mississippi State Penitentiary at Pacman, Marshall Turner. Oh, God, what you think of this, man?
I'm going to start off by saying this. First of all, it's a great thing to see this. And oftentimes people in the prison system, they kind of get, you know, forgot about. You know, people got this stigma and ideology that, okay, they did the crime, throw them away. I don't care how the prison is. I don't care if it's hot, it's cold. They did a crime. So they get thrown away. They get forgot about. I mean, this is a short of a godsend to have somebody, rappers, you know, using their time, money, and resources, you know, to try to address the forgotten about people, to try to get them some help. I mean, it's something that you see only in movies, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's a start. Obviously, we had a lot of different conversation. We went back and forth about Jay-Z. We don't agree with everything that he does, but we do agree with what he's trying to do in the prison system. We agreed 100% over here that, you know, we salute him, you know, and moving forward with his, you know, criminal justice initiative that he has, trying to get laws changed. Now taking the step to sue the prisons, because they always say, like, the only thing they're going to understand is large number of people, you know, and money, you know what I mean, and legality. So they'll keep going and they don't care because it's profitable. And, you know, throw them some food, put them in a hole, fuck them. That's the whole ideology. But now you got people that are big wigs, billionaires and millionaires now saying, all right, nah, we're going to step in and get some remedy for these people and get the law and take this thing to court. Now things begin to start changing. You know what I mean? So it's a lot of ways you can go about this, but I have to say 100% that I salute that. I don't know all the facts, you know, obviously what you read, but the gesture right now, I think, is 100% genuine. You only you could do is salute something like that, Sam, man.
Yeah, it's scary as hell when you think about it. When you think about the amount of black males and males of color who sit behind prison walls for nonviolent crimes. And like you elaborated to, when, and especially when we out here in the civilian world, when we hear somebody go to prison, we automatically throw them away like they're a piece of meat. Assuming that they're one way, assuming that they're all the same way and they're in prison for a reason, they don't deserve human rights. Where if I was not mistaken, it claims that the Eighth Amendment, which prohibits cruel and unusual punishment, is violated when prison officials fail to protect against prison related violence and when prison conditions fail to meet basic human needs. That's in the amendments. Yet you can look and listen to prison stories all throughout this country, whether it be in the county, whether it be a federal prison.
Yep.
Obviously, there's levels to certain wherever you're at. And these stories happen all the time. We see these kind of occurrences happening all the time. We see stories. I've seen plenty of stories back in 2019 of people looking for their family members or loved ones who happen to be inmates that they haven't heard from in a while. We're in a fight. We're in the infirmary and now not seen or heard from again. That would scare me to death. And to think that either one, it's a nonviolent crime, or two, they in there for the sole purpose of a quota being met and didn't really do anything wrong to begin with. When you talk about rappers like whoever's out there, in particular Yo Gotti and Jay-Z, giving hope to the hopeless and voice to the voiceless, how can you not salute this? These are people that are putting their money where their mouth is. Mm-hmm. They don't have to think about these men sitting in these conditions, obviously racially driven and motivated in a state like Mississippi where it's synonymous for the shit.
Yeah.
Salute.
Yeah,
Jay-Z and Yo Gotti for doing something, giving hope to the voiceless and the hopeless, man, because if they don't, who will? You know what I mean? And I hope people can follow more suit and start doing things like this once you get to a certain level, because I'm not saying that you ain't at Jay-Z's level going and donating and doing the things, but follow suit.
But it all is relative, though. They all can help on their own little level.
Exactly.
You know I mean, you don't have to be a billionaire, you know what I mean, to help causes like this. I mean, personally, I think that Jay-Z waited till he got to a point where he could be a financial powerhouse, a billionaire.
Makes sense.
Before he started, you know what I mean? Because again, if you know Jay-Z, like we both know him, listening to his music, he always had that message.